both teams, I mean, you know, we went through exams week, so we really, I was very, very concerned with this game coming in. Again, but, you know, I thought we did a real good job, especially the first half, of defending and rebounding. That's the thing I've been really harping on with this basketball team. I mean, we could score, but we need to defend and rebound. I thought we did a great job of doing that, especially the first half. We got them to turn the ball over 24 times, and then we were aggressive. We got 21 offensive rebounds, and, you know, it was a great team win. You know, we knew early on, I mean, the schedule was going to be very, very challenging for so many newcomers that we do have. And, you know, I think that that helped us, but now we got to carry it over. And that's why this was a good win for us.
Hey, Jim, you know what? In the first half there, I couldn't get the play out of my head. So it seemed like if you could encapsulate that game defensively for you guys, that relentlessness. McMillan comes back and blocks that shot on the Fanny kid. Did you notice that everything got like quiet for a split second? Like they couldn't quite believe what they saw?
No, I know.
Was that, what you're talking about?
Yeah, that was huge. I mean, you know, I mean, we're playing with a lot more grit and moxie, and that's what we have to carry over to every game. You know, we got to do the same thing. I mean, and again, it's, you know, we've been preaching about it. I've been preaching about it that, you know, we got to get tougher. We got to get more grittier. And, you know, I thought we did that tonight. Now we got to carry it over. So, you know, this is not a one-stop shop. And, you know, that's what happens when you graduate, you know, players. And all of a sudden, you know, we lose three starters last year. And now we're trying to fill in the void and playing against some good basketball. This was a good team.
Yep.
I mean, they beat Quinnipiac on the road. They beat Albany. They got five wins coming in, so this, I was very, very concerned. They could score the ball, shoot the ball. So, you know, I was very, very concerned. And plus, when you're in test week, you don't know. I mean, you see how stressed some of our kids were, you know, with just the whole week. But, you know, I mean, that's what we do. We graduate student-athletes, so it's important for us.
When you're looking up there, you had to be pretty happy because, I don't know, I don't know what the halftime score was, but they were stuck on 20 with like a minute and 11 left or something like that.
Yeah.
You got to be looking at the scoreboard, not even on your side, but their side, seeing 20 points. We're in pretty good shape here.
Yeah, no question. Well, we just, you know, we wanted to keep being aggressive, too, with attacking the basket. And I think that's why going to the glass, getting the ball inside. You know, we got to the foul line. I thought that was huge, getting 42 foul shots. You know, we got to use that. But, you know, I just thought that, you know, it was a great team effort. Turning them over 24 times, out rebounding them 41-28, and then get to the free throw line.
Right.
24 points behind the arc, 26 points in the paint, 29 points off turnover. You really have to love the balance that you guys got.
Well, it's important. You know, second chance points, we got 20 points. I mean, those are gritty points. You know, gritty points that we needed. Off the bench, we had 21 points. Off a turnover is 29. So those, you know, that's. You know, this is like the bad news bears. I mean, it's just, you know, we got different pieces of the puzzle, and we need everybody to be ready to go.
I don't know exactly, but Phil Valenti, I was looking at his freshman year. I think he took 25 three-pointers, and he's at 23 makes already this year. Can you say enough about it?
Just easy with that. Just take it one step at a time. It's like you're saying guys hit home runs, and all of a sudden the next 10 games they don't hit a home run.
Yeah.
Just, you know, easy. Just relax. It's all part of the, you know, it's all about being consistent, okay? Just take it one step at a time. And, you know, we got to be gritty to do all that stuff. That sounds great, but we could score the ball, but we got to defend, rebound, and then we got to, you know, we got to not turn it over and try to turn them over. So,
good to see you guys at the end there because things got a little tight.
Yeah.
And you guys got a little tight at the line.
Right.
To break through that, to overcome that little barrier.
Well, you got to play, you know, with aggressiveness and with confidence. And I thought that our guys stepped up and made the shots we need to make down the stretch.
You always talk about rebounding. Today you had more offensive rebounds than defensive, and that's huge. You always talk about working on that. What are – it's an all career, like what are coaching points for that?
We're going to bottle that and take that on the road because, you know, that's a lot of rebounds.
Right.
You know, we got to keep being consistent. The whole thing's going to come down to consistency.
Is that offensive rebounding, is that great, or like what are your coaching points to try to get better at that? Is it all just hustle, or what can you do to get better at that?
You got to keep working at it and stay consistent. There's not a lot of thinking, that's all playing. So you just got to be aggressive, and shot goes up, you got to go to the glass. And Jamal does it as well as NBA at 12. I mean, are you kidding me? He just goes to the glass.
That's it.
Okay.
All right, thank you, Coach.
Have a nice day.